Whoa, someone chose violence this morning. It's A back on your screen with another one. Hope you're well. I wanted to have a little fun with this one. So I asked you on the gram a couple questions, and these are your answers. I had to screen record all of the polls because when I try to zoom in to see the results, it clicks forward and backwards. It's so annoying. See? So if I try to see, okay, doing the most. Talk about life legally blind. First question is, first thing in the morning, coffee or tea? 65% said coffee, meanwhile 35% said tea. You know me, it's usually a matcha moment in the morning, so I would pick tea. But on days when I'm tired, nothing hits the way a latte would, especially a double shot espresso. It's hot. If you're not part of the Gram fam, what are you doing? Follow me at Alisha Inc. If you missed out on these polls and you want to still participate, let me know down below which one you choose. And also, to add a twist, coffee, hot or iced? Next pick. Next question. Are you a morning person or night owl? 32% said morning. Meanwhile, 68 said night owl. I used to be a morning person, or maybe I just thought I was a morning person until I worked a job that I had to be up and there by 7:30. Never again. I'm definitely a night owl now during Vlogmas. Sometimes I'm up until 3-4 editing a video to have it up in time. So, burning that midnight oil. Which holidays are better, winter or summer? 38 said winter, 62 said summer. I'm all about the summer vibes. What's better than May 2, 4, Canada Day, Labor Day weekend when you're having barbecues, you're out with your family and friends, you're patio hopping, you're enjoying the summer sun? Winter time, I get it. It's cozy. It's a nice vibe. But besides Christmas and Thanksgiving, what is there? Valentine's Day? Just like Thanksgiving, do you really need a day to be grateful for someone, or can you just do that 365? I'm not big on Christmas. The most I do, you see the candle? That's my Christmas decoration. Best bingeables. I feel like I played myself by wording it like this. I should have asked it differently. But 81% of you guys are about that Netflix and chill life. And only 19 live for HBO. Yo, why are you guys sleeping on HBO? They brought you Game of Thrones. Insecure? Come on. I should have said, instead of best bingeables, best series. Because when I think about it, excuse me, stop playing, pause. Ask this question differently, I would have put Hulu in the mix. Because if you really want to get down to it, Hulu has no chill. They're the ones that brought you Handmaid's Tale, right? And Dope Sick. They have some really twisted, all types of mind. Netflix, yes, the best bingeables. Look at all those people that watched Tiger King last year. I never got into that one, but Squid Games, that show was insane. Of course, I threw this question in here. Which year was worse, 2020 or 2021? So 47% said last year. Meanwhile, 53 said this year. I'd say this year too. A lot of things happened in my personal life that I can't get into, but yo, this year was a write-off. Yes, I'm grateful. Yes, there were some highlights. I had some good times. We made the most out of the moment. Take me out of it. If we look at the big picture, this year, we knew what was coming. Last year, a lot of people were saying 2020 is my year, turn of the decade. This year, nobody. Literally crickets. Nobody said this is my year. 2 weeks to the new year, still I don't hear anyone saying I'm claiming 2022. It's crazy in these streets. I don't think things are going to get better until 2024. I was watching something yesterday and they were saying, be positive, speak into, I don't even know. I don't believe in manifestation, so who knows? I hope I'm wrong. But the way that this year went and what I think next year is going to bring, we'll see. We'll just have to see. As long as we're happy and healthy. Favorite winter activity, skating or skiing? 79% said skating, while 21 said skiing. Ooh, you fancy, huh? I tried to ski that one time, but I nearly died when I tried. So I said, same for me. I'll stick to skating. That's enough Canadian for me. Ooh, this one's spicy. Which is better, sushi or tacos? 47% said sushi, 53% said tacos. It depends on the season. I'm all about a taco on a patio with a margarita. That's a summertime vibe. If you've seen the vlogs, you know I did that a lot last summer. But I would pick sushi. Something about it, it's just such a treat. And I just, it hits different. I love me some sushi. Rather splurge on travel or things? 53% said travel, 47% said things. I wish I could be team travel too, But I have to keep it real with you. My closets say otherwise. I definitely spend more on things than I do travel. Hopefully next year I can switch that around, especially since I'm losing more vision. I want to experience and see what I can see while I can still see the way I can see. Because as my vision deteriorates and people are pointing things out, I'm like, nah, I can't see that. So I wish I had traveled more when I could see better, but hey, make up for lost time next year, right? The oldest battle in the book, pet person, cat or dog. Surprise, surprise, you guys are split down the middle, 50-50 cat or dog. If I had to swing vote it, I'd say cat, although I'm not a pet person. Keep it real with you, almost every single one of my friends has a pet, so I don't need one. I'm too OCD for that. Between the fur, the messing up to the furniture, you have to clean up after them, is a no for me. But they're cute. A cute kitty or a little puppy to pet for a bit when you're chilling at a friend's house and you come home here, I'm good with that. Prefer to work out in class or solo dolo? Ooh, that's shocking. 21% said in class and 79% said solo dolo. I'm with you guys. I'd rather work alone. As much as I love the studio vibe, going in somewhere and feeling the energy if you're doing a yoga flow or if you're at the gym, I still like going down to my gym when there's no one there and feeling VIP and just getting in and getting out. Sometimes it's the person that's going hard for no reason on the treadmill that makes me want to go harder on the elliptical. I don't know what it is. Let me know if you feel the same. But when you are amongst people that are just going for it, sometimes it makes you work harder than you ever had before. Best way to shop, in store or online? 44% said in store. And very close, 56 said online. Can you guess which one I prefer? I'm all about that online shopping life, not just because I'm legally blind and it's actually easier to see when I can zoom in on the screen, but also because it's 24 hours. You don't have to get dressed up to go nowhere to click and put in your cart. Oh, this is my favorite question. Your vacation vibe, relaxing or adventurous? 63 said relaxing, 37 said adventurous. I'm with the minority in this one. I prefer adventurous, but really, it depends. Where are we going? Who are we going with? And what point and stage in our lives? Because a couple years ago when I did the all-inclusive, I was like, never again. If it wasn't for the excursions, I would have died. Staring at the sunsets every day, sipping by the sea, that's cool the first two nights. After that, I get a little itchy. Now, I think that I'm more mature and I can understand what it means to really relax and reset. I wouldn't mind that. But it depends where I'm going. If I'm going to South America or back to Africa or to Europe, adventure all day, every day. But if I'm going to Bora Bora, I'm going to the Caribbean, if I'm going anywhere where, you know, really just taking in and basking in the moment, relaxation. So it all depends. But I'd say I'm a little mix of both. You get tickets to concert or play. When I was writing this out, I was like, should I say concert or show? Will people know when I say show, I mean comedy, arts, podcast, that type of thing? So I put play, and then I was like, who watches plays anymore? I don't. I mean, I used to love them when I could still see, but me at a play, I can't see the people's faces. I don't know what's going on. I'm like, I can hear the voices the same way I would with music. So I'm with you guys. 68% said concerts. Meanwhile, 32% said plays. But if it was a show, would that swing your vote? I want to know. Are you a go-getter or procrastinator? Only 29% of you guys are carpe diem up in here. The rest of you guys, wait, 71%. I used to be a go-getter. I can be a go-getter, usually the first of the month, the week, the year, you know, that type of vibe. Lately, a procrastinator. There's something about leaving it to the last minute and then being on your grind. I feel like I produce my best videos when I leave it to the last minute, even though I know I shouldn't. And also just having that timeline and that structure so you're not taking your time to get it perfect and go back again, that kind of thing. But I really need to work on that next year. I had to throw a blind question in there. If you had to choose, would you rather be blind or deaf? 20% said blind. The rest of you guys said deaf. 80%, man. You guys can even pretend for a little bit. No one wants to be blind like me. I see. I mean, I don't see, but I see. This question is like a trick question. Someone actually DM'd me about this. She said she hates this question because she got it asked a lot when she was first diagnosed. I don't know. Like, I know what it's like to lose vision, but I don't know what it's like to lose sound or hearing, I should say. That might have its own world of difficulties. I mean, being disabled in general sucks. So can I say it's easier or more difficult? Like, what's worse? not hearing someone run up on you or not seeing them run up on you. Like, I don't know. I would still go with deaf though, because I have the experience of losing vision. I figure not being able to hear music as well or hear people speaking, is that going to impede me as much as not being able to drive or not be able to read? Or if you are like living with RP, you can't really walk around without a dog or a cane. So can you drive when you're deaf? Because depending on how visually impaired you are, you can't drive when you're legally blind. So that would be a swing vote for me. Because if I could drive while deaf, which I don't think is safe because then you can't hear people honking. I don't know. If you're deaf, educate me. I want to know. Consider yourself spiritual or nah? So 47% said spiritual, 53% said nah. I feel like our generation is the least religious spiritual of all. If I asked this 20 years ago, I'm sure it'd be more spiritual. I am a Christian and I do believe in energy and higher entities. And if you want to talk about that more, I will. And also see why a lot of people are turned off from religions and the biases that they have. So if that's why you're not, let me know down below. I'd love to know. Set the mood, candles or essential oils? 75% candles with only 25% saying essential oils. Ooh, candles are making a comeback. Because I remember when it was corny to give a candle as a gift. Like, that's a gift you give to someone when you forget to give them a gift. Whereas now I go out of my way to find the perfect candle to give a loved one or to give myself. Look, candle in the background. But even saying all of that, I'm about those essential oils. If I had to choose to only burn candles or essential oils, it would be essential oils. First of all, I don't have to find the wick. You know how hard it is for a blind person to light a white wick against a white wax? Mm. Secondly, I can leave it unattended. I don't have to worry about burning my house down if I go to take a shower or if it's windy, if I have the window open. I can have it on all day. The fumes, the smoke, the vapor, whatever comes out is a whole vibe. And I like to mix and match and make my own blends. This feels like such a classic would you rather question. Would you rather never have to work again or never need to sleep again? So we have, wow, 80% said work, while 20% said sleep. Honestly, I didn't think so many people would say sleep. What are you gonna do if you never sleep? Just work all day? I wanna know. I love sleeping, okay? I love dreaming. I have the most lucid dreams. I could compete with Steven Spielberg in my mind, but at the same time, I also have those night terrors. No, are they called night terrors or night paralysis? You know when you're asleep and there's like demons in your house? Yeah, I get that shit all the time. It's not fun, so pray for me. Another blind question. Would you rather be legally blind over time or at birth? And 64 said over time. Meanwhile, whoop, it skipped. 64% said over time, and then at birth was 36%. Coming from someone who's been legally blind over time, I actually don't know. On one hand, is it better to have loved and lost than to never have loved at all? That kind of thing. I've had blind people tell me, you're so lucky you can still see, you're not really blind, X, Y, and Z. Try living my life, fam. Like, I don't judge other blind people. I can't say if it's hard or easy. What I can say is from my own experience, the days that I get hung up mentally the most is when I'm just like, I used to be able to do this a few years ago. Like, knowing that this was something you could do easily that you can't do now, it really plays with your mind. But at the same time, I'm grateful that I was able to do and experience and see and be someone who wasn't visually impaired for so long in my life. So I would still prefer over time. The only thing I would say is if I was legally blind at birth, there would be nothing to miss, right? Because I can only imagine. I wouldn't have actually experienced it. If you're legally blind, let me know how you feel about this question. And if you can see perfectly, would you rather be legally blind, so have some sight that gets worse over time, or have no sight, so just one and done? Because sometimes I'm like, yo, is this worse than just not being able to see again? Because sometimes I see things, but I can't see, so it's like teasing me. But maybe that's just me. Last question, this one is just for fun. Biggest turn off, bad breath or BO? 47 said bad breath, 53% said BO. You know what? Bad breath, Tic Tac. I can buy you one of those tongue scrubbers. Mouthwash, maybe you need to floss because there's a lot of stink in between them teeth. But if you have BO and you're grown, where can we go from here? That's what I want to know. Like, when I used to work in the middle school, those seventh graders tank. But when it's the first warm days in Toronto, not the heat wave, just when it starts to warm up a little bit in the spring, and I'm on the subway and all those grown people smell, I'm just like, we've been through this enough cycles in our lives. Put on extra deodorant. What's going on? If I were to go on a date and someone's had bad breath, 6 feet distance, and I'll probably tell them at the end of the date, like, yo, because I'd want to know. But if that guy smells bad, like, there's something seriously is wrong. I have to just assume something is seriously wrong if you're grown and you don't know you smell. So it's a no for me. Those are all the questions I have this go around. If you like this video, let me know by hitting the like button. I can make this a monthly thing. I had a lot of fun seeing your responses, and a lot of you guys commented too. So I hope you guys enjoy this one. If you did, tap the like, comment down below what you want to see next, because I'm thinking in January we can do one related to goals or maybe what we foresee for the future. February can be all about love or maybe a naughty version, who knows. We'll see how this goes. So until next time, stay safe, stay sane, stay blessed. Love and later. So good.